Hello friends, today in trick number 145 we are going to start a series of tricks in which I will tell you how we can remember various formulas which are associated with the topic of trigonometry, a very important topic because it starts at the level of class 10th and does not stop till a person studies mathematics. And trigonometry is involved in other subjects also, like physics includes a lot of topics which involve the use of trigonometry. So a deep understanding of this topic is required to pursue physics and mathematics studies at higher level. So we will just try and understand the concept of a right angle triangle first, because in a right angle triangle one angle is 90 and other two angles are acute. So in trigonometry the acute angle is denoted by theta. This is theta, the symbol for theta. And when we consider one of the two acute angles, then the angle which we have considered fixes the perpendicular and the base of the right angle triangle. Because if you draw a right angle triangle, the hypotenuse is fixed, it is the side opposite to 90 degree. But out of the remaining two sides, one is base and one is perpendicular. You can name any side as the base and the other one as perpendicular. But in trigonometry, we have to fix the perpendicular and the base. So that perpendicular and base is fixed by taking the angle theta. Suppose in this figure, we are considering this angle as theta. So the side which is common to the 90 degree angle and the angle theta is this one. So this side which is common to the two angles will be called the base, or we can call it the adjacent side. The remaining side apart from hypotenuse and the base, this one, it is opposite to the angle theta. So this will be called opposite side, or we can name it as the perpendicular. Likewise, if you change the acute angle, if angle under consideration now is labeled here as theta, then obviously this side is common between the angle theta and 90 degree. So this side now will be called as base or the adjacent side, and the side which is opposite to theta, that will be known as the perpendicular or the opposite side. So this is the very important concept which a child has to know when he or she is starting the trigonometry topic. Unless and until one is clear about the concept of base and perpendicular, everything in trigonometry is waste after that. So after having understood the concept of base, perpendicular and hypotenuse, we need to understand how the relation between the acute angle and sides of a right angle triangle is obtained using trigonometry. For studying any topic, you need to understand the terminology of that topic. And in trigonometry also, we have some trigonometric terms, some functions which we have to know. So these six functions are basically sine, cosine, tangent, cotangent, secant and cosecant. These are the six trigonometric functions which have to be remembered in a particular order, the order in which I have written it on the board, so that it becomes easier for remembering all the identities related to trigonometry. Since all these are actually words and difficult to write again and again, so we take only first three alphabets of each word. So this makes it sin, but we will call it sine. Cosine becomes cos, tangent becomes tan, cotangent becomes cot, secant becomes sec, and cosecant, if we write the first three alphabets, then it gets repeated here. So we will take the first five alphabets, cosec. In itself, all these six trigonometric functions do not have any meaning. So in order to convert them into a meaningful one, we need to write or suffix the acute angle under consideration. It is theta. So two acute angles, we have to consider one of them. Say I am considering the angle theta. Now these six trigonometric functions are meaningful. Sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta and cosec theta, all six trigonometric functions now have a meaning. And remember, sin and theta are not two different things. Sin theta is actually a value. Sin cannot be separated from theta. They attain a meaning only when they are combined together. All these six trigonometric functions are actually ratios, so we also call them as trigonometric ratios, and they are ratios of the three sides of a right angle triangle, that is the hypotenuse, perpendicular and the base, or you can call hypotenuse opposite side and the adjacent sides. So when you have to remember which ratio belongs to which trigonometric function, then there are a number of ways in which you can remember these six formulas. The easiest one of them is basically like you can remember it through this acronym. Say we have sin, S stands for sin. So I will take this opposite side as O. I will represent this as O. The adjacent side with A and the hypotenuse with H. So S stands for sin theta. It is actually the ratio of O and H. So we have one word here, SOH. Then come to cos theta, C. C stands for cos. Take A from here and H from here. CAH becomes the second word you have to remember. And the third, T. T stands for tan. So O and A. So if you remember these three words, then first set of formula of trigonometry will be very easy. So sin theta is actually the ratio of opposite side and the hypotenuse. So opposite side and the hypotenuse. Or you can also call it as perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Similarly, cos theta is the ratio of adjacent side to the hypotenuse. Or you can also call it as base upon hypotenuse, because adjacent side is actually the base. Tan theta, opposite side upon adjacent side. Or you can also call it as perpendicular upon base. Now, having understood these three formulas using this acronym SOH, CAH and TOA, we can write other three formulas. Very simple. You just need to know that actually sine and cosec, the first and last one, are reciprocals of each other. Cos and sec, they are reciprocals of each other. And tan and cot, they are reciprocals of each other. So if we remember the first three, then you can write the next three functions. If you have to write the formula for cosec theta, just see the formula of sin theta. It is opposite by hypotenuse, so it becomes hypotenuse upon opposite side. Or you can call it H upon P, hypotenuse upon perpendicular, because this was P by H, so it becomes H by P. Sec theta is the reciprocal of cos theta, so adjacent by hypotenuse becomes hypotenuse by adjacent. or you can also call it as hypotenuse upon base. And finally, cot theta is the reciprocal of tan theta. So this was opposite by adjacent, so it becomes adjacent by opposite. Or you can also write it as base upon perpendicular. So this is the first set of formula which relates the acute angle of a right angle triangle with the sides of a right angle triangle. So after having understood these six formulas of trigonometry, we can move on to the next set of formula in our next video, wherein we will learn how we can arrive at the formulas for complementary angles and some standard angles which will be used to find the values of trigonometric functions. So keep learning, keep sharing, and subscribe the channel if you like it.